bum, 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 bum. Got a date with an angel. You're off key.
Gonna be tonight, an hour of music.
Got a date with an angel.
Laughter.
If the dog hadn't stopped to pee, he might have caught the rabbit.
Fashion.
I can't see my feet, can you? I forgot to put my shoes on.
Okay, that's all right.
And romance.
To heaven.
Darling. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Brando, next on Larry King Live. Many times over the weekend, we presenting on Larry King Live what we call King's Classics, interviews from the past. This one occurred 9 years ago in 1994. We went up to Marlon Brando's house. He said he would do one interview for his book. He chose our show. We drove around earlier that day, had lunch, and then the scene was set. It was different. It was fun. Watch. Explain what you did. Don't put me on, Marlon. You put your own makeup on today.
I did, because I wanted to look exactly like you. And
this was your goal?
This is my goal.
And you believe?
I wore some red suspenders in your honor.
Oh, my God.
I did everything I could, and then I've received some criticism from these people. Think.
They wanted to do you themselves.
They wanted to do it themselves.
Well, I'm honored. Do you see my eyebrows that dark in that way, in that kind of dark look?
Yes, a little of the, what do you call it? Who was that guy, the famous Italian guy? Not Raymond Navarro, but the other guy. Oh, the big lover. What was his name? Played the Sheik.
Oh, Valentino.
Yeah,
that's Valentino. The look you have.
That's right.
Why? I want to touch a lot of bases with you. It's not easy to get to. Why don't you like interviews?
Well, primarily because the interest is in money. That's the principal guiding feature of all interviews today, is money.
What do you mean?
You know perfectly well what I mean.
No.
You know that a story has... that one story is more valuable than another because of the readership. For instance, O.J. Simpson has taken over the airway. Just sweating a little. O.J. Simpson has taken over the airway. What are you smiling at?
I'm smiling because she's pointed out that I was sweating. I'm Jewish. I sweat. You're part Yiddish. You understand. Okay, and that's money. So you say that the camera go...
No, it's been forced because it's market forces that determine that. There are a lot of guys like Izzy Stone. Do you remember Izzy Stone?
Wonderful. I have Stone, the giant.
Fred Friendly, who's still alive, who still is throwing punches, still going three rounds.
But the question was, why don't you like being interviewed?
Because I don't like the idea of selling yourself for money.
So you don't like selling a book, right? You don't like to go on to sell a book or sell a movie.
I don't. I've never sold a movie, and this is the first time I've ever been on beating the drum for some product. In this case, it's Random House's book.
Because you promised them you would do one?
It was, unbeknownst to me, it was part of the contract. And if I didn't, I would be... But I would be in breach of contract. But aside from that, I've had pleasure talking to you. I'm fascinated with people, especially the kind of people. I wouldn't lump you with others because you are exceptional, because there are many people have asked me to be on programs and I've refused. But you, without flattery, I mean, I have nothing to gain. You have impressed, I think, all people, and certainly me, as being very forthright, sincere, and direct, and
well, I thank you very much.
And
now the subject is you. Why?
No, not necessarily.
Yeah, but in this show,
because the
you.
Audience really would like to know what it is that makes Larry King.
Okay. Well, one night we'll have Marlon Brando live. You'll host it. I'll guest.
That's this night.
No, this night you're the guest.
Somebody laughed over there.
Why did you choose acting as a career? Why did you choose to be other people?
I think it's useful to make an observation about that. That everybody here in this room is an actor. You're an actor. And the best performances that I've ever seen is when the director says, cut. And the director says, that was great, that was wonderful, that was good. He said, we had a little lighting problem, let's do it again. What he's thinking is, Jesus Christ, that's so fucking... Excuse me. It's that's It wasn't done well, so we've got to do it over. But everybody tries to handle. When you say, how do you do, how are you, you look fine, you're doing two things at once. You're reading the person's real intention, mm-hmm. you're trying to feel who he is, and making an assessment, and trying to
the director
ignore the mythology.
So when the director says, cut, but I didn't like the lighting, he's acting.
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about going to the office and saying, good morning, Mr. Harrison.
I know, but we're all acting.
And we're all acting.
But why did you choose it?
And it's a natural. What?
You chose it as a profession.
Because there isn't anything that pays you as much money as acting while you are deciding what the hell you're going to do with yourself.
So wait a minute. Are you saying you're still deciding?
It took me a long time to decide. You know, people have never decided. I mean, most people, if you ask them what their dreams are, mm-hmm. give this guy a clean.
I'll get a tissue in a while. Go ahead, I sweat. We got hot lights here.
No, we don't. I'm not sweating.
Right, well, you're Marlon Brando, I'm Larry King. I sweat.
You're a darling man. I don't know. Why are you sweating?
I don't want to get off.
Why do you escape trying to make a one-to-one contact here? Because I'm the product?
Yeah, you're the product, right?
Okay, then you answered your
first
question.
This is about money, then.
This is about money.
But it's also about interest and learning.
If I was Joe Schlipp, I don't think I'd be sitting here, even though you might like me, even though we went for a taxi ride. And I was a very interesting guy. I don't know that I would appear in your program.
You are correct.
And
but you've attained
because
something.
Of market values.
But you've attained something that people are interested in. That's why there's a market value. That's why they pay you the money to do the film.
Yes, that's precisely
okay.
it.
So when Brando goes up on the screen or on the marquee, people will come to see the movie. That's money.
That's
and brings
right.
money to you.
It's market forces. Okay. That's the way it works. But if you don't carry the mail, you don't get arrested. Right.
Did it come easily to you? So in other words, you could make money this way?
Acting comes easily to everybody. All I've done is just simply through the extraordinary talents of Stella Adler, who was my teacher and mentor, learned how to be aware of the process. And some people are never aware of it, and
professionally. Or she taught you
in life.
Or
in
she
life.
Taught you how to what impersonate?
No, how to be aware of my own feelings, and how to access my own feelings. Many actors can do that. I'm sure you've seen pictures of actors that. I mean, you've seen a performance of an actor who really gave his all, and he was very effective, but he was ugly. He was ugly in the expression of his emotion. Or he was truly being himself, but what he was boring. Or was dull, or was right. something.
So she taught you to take that inner self of you and bring it to a waterfront or
I'm
a godfather or a whatever.
I'm not sure what she taught me. We'd all like to be certain of what we know. But I think the most important question is to ask yourself, do you really know what you know?
Okay, help me with something because it's fascinating. Let's say you get a role. It's the godfather.
Yeah.
You're not a mafia kingpin.
Yes,
you're...
I am. So are you.
No, you're not a mafia.
Yeah. Well, as a matter of fact, I'm not.
Okay.
But we are. There isn't anything that you are, or that you feel, or that you have, that I don't feel, or that I don't have in some
but
measure.
But you can bring it into someone.
You can ask an actor, well, here, this is what you get. You get hit with a crowbar in the head, and you get a brain concussion. You're lying there, and you're mumbling. Well, I mumble anyway, but...
Okay, saying anyone...
Nobody can die, so you have to pretend you're dying.
Okay, are you saying that when you are the godfather, you're pretending?
Sure. I'm pretending.
But you're in...
I mean, we're going to get lost in vocabulary.
No, we're not. We're learning what you're doing. What do you do? You read the script. You like it. By the way,
I usually read the script and hate it.
You usually hate it, but you didn't hate The Godfather, right?
No, I liked the... I wasn't sure that I could do it, and Francis fortunately asked me if I would do a...
test?
Yeah, a test, which I wasn't... I would never play a part that I couldn't do. And somebody asked me to play Hamlet tomorrow with Jesus Christ playing Mary Magdalene. I wouldn't do it.
Have you turned down anything you regretted?
That I regretted? No.
Ever taken anything you regretted?
oh, God. Taken anything? You mean swipe stuff?
No, no, no. Played a role. You, God, I'm sorry.
Oh, yes, of course.
A lot of them?
No, regretted, no. I think this, the regret is useless in life. It belongs to the past. The only moment we have is right now, sitting here and talking with each other. You can't see my feet, can you? I forgot to put my shoes on.
Okay, that's allowed. It's your house. This is the moment. We'll come back with more of these moments, okay? I'll take a break.
Okay.
Make money.
All right.
We'll be right back. Don't go away.
You look terrible. I should eat. I want you to rest well, and a month from now, this Hollywood big shot's gonna give you what you want.
Too late. They start shooting in a week.
I'm gonna make them an offer they can't refuse.
You put that howling down there and go to bed.
Yes, I want my girls out here.
You shut up. You're going to get the law on you.
Stella!
You can't beat on a woman and then call her back because she ain't going to come. You're going to have a baby.
Listen,
I'll say haul you in and turn a foul.
Yes,
like
I want
the
girls
last
out here.
You stink.
Hey, Stella!
Back to movies, and we'll touch a lot of base. I want to talk about the environment, Tahiti, the causes you get involved in.
I'm glad you said that, so we can get off of movies.
I know, but there's certain things I want to...
fascinating
just
topic
to
in
take
the
me back.
Oh,
do you ever
shoes.
Miss theater?
Only when I'm going around 47th Street, about 80 miles an hour in a cab. And I...
And you say you'd like to be inside
no,
there?
No, I passed by the Alvin and almost hit it. That's when I...
You do not miss being on a stage.
No. God,
why
no.
Not?
Because it's 3 hours of blood, sweat, and tears every night. There's nothing to do but blah, 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 blah.
Oh, don't diminish that.
What?
Audience. You...
I don't diminish Shakespeare. I can recite Shakespeare from morning till night till I put you to sleep. I love Shakespeare, but I don't like... I'm not nuts about going to theater. So often in the past, I've gone to the theater and been so bored.
How about working in it, though? I mean, first of all, you get applause.
What for?
The applause.
Who cares about applause? If I get applause from my dog, if I get applause from my children, that's enough. God, do I have to turn into an applause junkie in order to feel good about myself?
When you start...
How about you? Do you need applause? Larry, not that was a great show.
I need, I need
God,
acceptance.
I've never seen you so stimulated and so inspired in asking the questions of this person. And but you think, oh, God, oh, it's new.
Tell this Yiddish thing, you got a lot of that in New York, right? You're part Jewish.
Technically I'm not a Jew, but culturally I am. I spent 10 years. In New York, and New York was when New York was New York, the Daily Forwards. And Stella very kindly invited me into her home. And all of my employers, my teachers, I went to the New School of Social Research, which is an extraordinary institution of learning.
Still there.
And it was at a time when all the people were coming out of this extraordinary academia of Germany, and like Hannah Arendt and Zucker, the list is endless.
You read them all?
I never had a chance to take her class. She taught at the New School of Social Research. It was sort of a clearinghouse until they went on to Princeton or Yale.
So at this time, did you realize, even at this young age, I am doing acting because I can do it? But
we
I wanted.
We were talking about Yiddish.
But
New York.
I want to do other things.
What?
But did you realize it then that I wanted to.
I studied for a while to be a dancer at Catherine Dunham's School of Dance, and I formerly had been a trap drummer, a stick drummer, and I got. I was encapsulated in Puerto Rican music.
Would you rather have been a musician?
I don't know. If the dog hadn't stopped to pee, he might have caught the rabbit. How could I possibly know?
Well, because you know if you love it.
What? I'll do it right now.
Are you going to? Oh, Marlon has a way to stop sweating.
I have a way.
The Brando method.
That Larry doesn't know about of taking sweat off your brow.
What do you do?
Just leave it there and it'll, it will.
But how does this look?
What? It looks like that.
All right.
Take a look at the camera. A
few more things on acting and then I want to touch other base, but on acting.
Acting is the most important thing in the world because...
We all do it.
We all do it, and we do it for a reason. For a sociological... It serves a sociological purpose. And when you think of it, it's an absurd process because I go and I pretend that I've got a hole in my leg and because I'm limping on one side, this girl won't fall in love with me and her grandmother is trying to arrange a marriage, some crazy thing. And people go to a dark room and pay money to see somebody pretend that they've got a hole in their leg.
Now you're making light of it. But in pretending you've got the hole in the leg...
Because it is a... It's older than whoring. It's older than being a whore. Because if you examine the behavior of chimpanzees or other related ape groups, you see it in many different animal species, but especially amongst gorillas. If you look the gorilla right in the face, a grayback, a silverback gorilla, he would most likely attack you because, and that's not very far from the drunk who's in a bar. When you look at him, he says, "Who the hell you think you're looking at? Huh?" And so either you take your legs off. Either you take.
but back to the point though, if you can, if you can make me understand the man with the hole in the leg and what that feels like, the pain of the loss of the wife or the grandmother.
We all have related pain. For instance, if I'm sad, you don't know what I'm sad about. You can say in a play, he's sad because his life is so full of emptiness, or he dreads getting cancer of the nose or something like that. And all I have to do is think about something that reminds me of the sadness that I've had.
Okay,
in my mind.
You'll bring that to whether it's a disappointment in On the Waterfront, an anger in The Godfather, right? Or a scene in Viva Zapata. You bring that emotion, that feeling, to whether you're on a horseback
or
on a gangplank.
Or, my dear friend, a reasonable facsimile thereof. Because you don't know whether I'm feeling it or not. As long as I can convince you that I am, I've done my job.
The willing suspension of disbelief, right? That's what a good actor makes me do.
No. A willing suspension to believe, to not to disbelieve.
To believe.
It's
a willing to disbelieve that that's Marlon Brando, but that is in fact...
A willingness to believe.
Yeah, to believe that you're not Brando,
but
you're the Godfather.
It's part of the process because you pay hard cash. You have to pay the babysitters, you have to pay for the popcorn, you have to pay for the tickets. You have to pay for a lot of things besides getting robbed on the way to the movie. So
you've got to willingly suspend and believe. All right, let me get a break. We'll come back with Marlon Brando. There's lots of other things to talk about.
I'm leaving now. It doesn't matter what he says.
No, and we're going to take. phone calls. You love Don Rickles, right? Tell him.
I love Don Rickles.
He loves Don Rickles.
I want to know how it is that you comb your hair with a wash rag so successfully.
That's
terrific.
We'll be right back with Mr. B. Don't go away.
Not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is often turned with their bones. So let it be with Caesar.
You've given your last command, Bly. I'll have those keys, Friar.
You heard my order.
One more order, Mr. Bly, and I'll have your head on this stick. By heaven, I swear it.
Why Tahiti?
Tahiti, one thing that has been very problematic about being an actor and getting some measure of celebrity is the fact that you lose your identity. And everybody calls you instantly Mr. Brando instead of Hey You. And then people make up notions, they want your autograph. And I used to shovel manure from horses and cows for a living. I milk cows. I have done some really, I've dug ditches, real ditches for Malcolm Ball's father in Libertyville, Illinois. And I was an elevator boy at Best and Company, and I was a short order cook for a while, and a sandwich man, a waiter.
Right, and then you got famous and rich.
And then your life changes. You don't change, but suddenly there's a lot more girls saying, "Hi, Mar."
And that's good, ain't it?
I used to think it was good until it took me a while to realize that it was just part of the game. And I always wanted to be liked for myself, known to myself. So anyway, long story short.
So why Tahiti?
I went to Tahiti where they don't give a damn who you are. The Tahitians are marvelously free. First of all, it's a classless society. And if you put on airs, they just tease the life out of you. And
so ego don't work there?
What?
Ego don't work there.
Doesn't work there. Well, ego works, but not for long, because they tease you so much that you have to you get rid of it pretty good.
What has fame done to you, if anything?
It's made me feel kind of isolated and a little alone. It's but the society I know and trust are the people that I have known for a long time and loved.
Are you happier now?
And I'm happy now. Most of the time, I'm happy. I have a few blips now and then, but it took me a long time to hit my stride.
Were you ever what might be termed depressed?
I was never depressed.
Were you ever?
I had trouble
mood swings.
With, what?
Mood swings.
No, wasn't mood swings. I was. I think that I was mostly an angry guy.
Your childhood.
A quick temper, quick to fight, and I had a bad
tough
bringing
childhood,
up.
Right? Huh? You had a tough childhood.
Well, it's all relative. There's some guys, one of my very closest friends was Jimmy Baldwin.
Wonderful.
Who was a black kid who was brought up in the Amen Corner. And I met him when I was 18. And we were instant friends. And
he had it tougher than you.
First of all, he was black, which is tough to grow up in this country. Secondly, he was dominated by his father, who was not such a wonderful man, according to what he told me. And he wanted to be a writer, which at that time was a very, very, there weren't any black writers. He was one of the first black writers that we had that achieve popularity.
So when you say it's relative, you can look at Baldwin and say, I had it better than he did.
I can look at him and say, maybe he had something to He had a capacity to deal with life. I know people who have it worse than I have.
But does that make it easier for you because they had it worse?
What?
Does that make it easier for you because they had it worse?
It's all relative. It's very, very difficult to say when somebody is brave or when somebody is, let's say, cowardly. Because what might be a brave choice for you, for another person, is just, they just simply don't experience fear.
Okay.
So it doesn't mean anything.
Did you use that anger ever on a pro sense? In other words, anger's not a very good thing to have. Did you ever use it, say, in your career to your benefit?
Well, I suppose, when you're acting, you'd have to be angry at something. You think of something that makes you...
All right. What changed you? What diminished the anger?
Pain. I knew I had to deal with it, and I had to find out why I was angry, as we all do. And as opposed to you, from what we've said before, I believe that unless we look inwards, we will not ever be able to clearly see outwards.
We were talking before we went on the air that I have a difficult time looking inward, so, and Marlon was kind of analyzing this. You can look inward, right?
I have the sense that I can. In any event, the total result is that I have felt much calmer, and I've had moments of real tranquility since I just put a brake on everything, and just I've done a lot of meditation.
Professional help too.
I was uselessly psychoanalyzed and exploited by psychoanalysts, or maybe sometimes sincerely. I don't want to degrade their intentions, but they make a lot of money getting you 5 days a week to lie down and say, I understand that your mother used to like to pinch your blackheads. What does that mean to you? And
so what did you use beyond...
This one guy who I do want to thank was named G.L. Harrington. And he was like my father, and I thought, oh, Christ, we're going to end up in fisticuffs because he was a really tough guy, and he spoke like that, and he was... You know, he had a lot of male hormones, and he shook your hand, and he crushed it. And I thought, wait a minute, buddy. This isn't, I don't know if this is going to work out. In any event, he was wonderful. He laughed me out of a lot of trouble. What are you looking at? You watch
I do. I just want to check, because I don't have a clock here, so I'm checking times. There's a lot of base I want to cover. Time goes so fast with you. For someone who doesn't do interviews, you're a great interview subject.
Oh.
So I just thought I'd pass that along to you.
Okay.
We'll be right back with Marlon Brando. Don't go away.
I don't have a name.
You want to know my name?
No, no, I don't. I don't want to know your name. You don't have a name, and I don't have a name either. No names here. Not one name.
You're crazy.
Maybe I am, but I don't want to know anything about you. I don't want to know where you live or where you come from. I want to know nothing, nothing, nothing.
Horror. Horror has a face, and you must make a friend of horror. Horror and moral terror are your friends. If they are not, then they are enemies to be feared.
Let's take some calls for Marlon Brando, Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Hello.
Hello, Mr. Brando.
Yes.
Hi, I just wanted to ask you, considering that you are...
What is your name, please?
Natalia.
Natalia.
Yes.
Oh.
Okay, calm, Marlon. Go ahead, Natalia.
Okay, considering that you're a very private person, why after so many years of obscurity, of refusing to be in the spotlight, have you decided to publish your autobiography?
I think that you have misunderstood something. I wouldn't be on that program, on this program. Somebody in Louisiana, a woman, I don't know who she was, said anybody who shows his face in public is an ass. And perhaps that's true by some standards. In any event, fate has brought me to this moment.
All right, her question was, why did a private person write an autobiography?
Oh, I was just explaining to Larry that the reason that I wrote it was, it was an exercise in freedom. I want to be able to say to you, or to Larry, or to myself, anything that I believe to be true. And it's a very, very difficult thing to do, to go through life. And one of the things that, in this culture, money is everything. Money is God. Money is our religion. And it determines everything that we do. And also...
So they paid you to do what? This. They paid you to do the book.
They paid me $5 million to write the story of my life, but I decided to do it before. And
but you would
no
also
one
do
offered
things
it.
For nothing. You did a movie for nothing, right?
I did the last, next to the last movie I did for nothing.
Justice and law, Mr. DeTroy, are often just, well, I suppose they could be described as distant cousins, and here in South Africa, they're simply not on speaking terms at all.
Now we're going to show you a side of Brando you may not know since Guys and Dolls. We're going to do a tune, right? What tune do you want to do?
Let's see. What about Limehouse Blues?
No, I don't know Limehouse Blues. But you can sing. You want to do Limehouse Blues? Do it.
Well, what song do you know?
Well, what's the one we were just doing? I've flown around the world in a plane.
All right.
Okay.
I've flown around the world. Let me get my brushes up, my wire brushes up.
I've flown around the world in a plane. I've designed the latest solutions in Spain.
Fame.
With
and
Queens.
The North Pole I have charted.
But I
still
I can't get
started with you.
Oh, you're jazzing. Go.
On the golf course.
I'm under par.
That's right. Metro Goldwyn has asked me to star. Hey. I've got a house.
A show place.
A show place.
But I can't get...
Still, I can't get no place with you. That's because you ask too many questions. You don't give me a chance to answer.
Let me take another call. Zurich, Switzerland. Hello.
This is Sammy from Zurich. It's fascinating to talk to two legends at the same time.
Two legends at the same time, Sammy from
Zurich. Bonsoir, monsieur.
Yes, Larry,
vous parlez français?
I'm sure that all the free thinkers in the world would agree with me that you deserve a Nobel Prize of your own.
For what?
Collective one. I'm sorry, I'm not sure when I could be in there again, so I had to
Do
say
you have
this.
A question for Mr.
Yes.
B?
Mr. Brando, you had a political and social agenda sometimes. You defended the American Indians, for example.
Yes.
You were an inspiration for us when we were in the best boarding school in Egypt at times, too.
Very strong.
Have you ever considered
racism?
A political career in your life, like President
Ever
Reagan,
want to run for office? Thank you, sir.
Yes, Larry has cut you off.
Well, he got just, to his point, and I'm moving
yes,
it along.
Okay.
I didn't cut him off. I cut him off.
I was, I have been in support of the Jews who came out of the concentration camp to try to find a home for them. I was in support of the Indians in America, who I think America has seduced. 400 treaties, read them, 400 treaties have been broken by the United States government. If one time Cuba said, I'm sorry, we don't recognize the Treaty of Guantanamo, they'd have the Marines in there in eight
Fast.
Seconds. They'd bomb Havana flat. They'd make a parking lot out of it. Why is it that we cannot give, one-third of America is owned by the U.S. government. The blacks in this country have struggled, have fought, have died of misery and broken hearts, perfectly and wonderfully documented in the best writer of the world, in my estimation, Toni Morrison, in her books. And I think they should be read everywhere in the world to have a sense. Don't look at your watch.
I know, I got to get a break. We're going to do more of this. We just touched the surface.
Anyway.
Have you ever wanted to run for office?
I wanted to run from office. But never for office.
We'll be back with some
Thank
more
you.
Moments with Marlon Brando. Where doth that little Shakespeare, the time go? Our chair's moving. Don't go away.
So let's keep the party polite. Never get out of my sight. stick with me, baby. I'm the fella you came in with. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady tonight.
You was my brother, Charlie. You should have looked out for me a little bit. You should have taken care of me just a little bit so I wouldn't have to take them dives for the short end money.
Well, I had some bets down for you. You saw some money.
You don't understand. I could have had class. I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody. Instead of a bum, which is what I am. Let's face it.
By the way, there's nothing in this house, in this wonderful house, that says you're an actor. Okay? There's no theater billboards. There's no movie cutouts. There's no Oscar. Where's your Oscar?
I don't know.
You don't know where your Oscar is?
I think my secretary has it.
George C. Scott said...
I know one guy that has it, but...
George C. Scott said that he doesn't want to ever compete because he thinks competition among actors is wrong unless all of them play the same part.
Originally, I think that the Academy Awards was determined because of... Or rather, it was put together by some very cogent businessmen who thought that they would improve their product if they had a gala and all of that stuff. And that was when Hedda Hopper and the fat one?
Luella Parson
were running the show. And it came out of that, and now people take it very seriously. And,
do you?
No, I don't believe in any kind of award, no matter what it is.
Because?
And I don't believe in any kind of censure.
No censure, no awards.
No
awards, why?
Because I don't think that I'm any better than the camera operator, the boom man. I don't think that I'm any better than you are.
But in your
and
profession...
And I don't think that they're better than I am. They all have their personal, intimate...
So in a Brando world, there would be no Emmys or Tonys or award shows.
In a Brando world?
A Brando?
I don't know. It's hard to envision that. I suppose if I were king of the world.
Okay. By the way, did you want good reviews?
I never read reviews.
You know, people say that. That's really true. You never read. You wouldn't say, if I said to you, Marlon.
I have read reviews.
The Washington Post tomorrow gives
reviews.
You a
generally,
rave.
I don't, and I don't see. The movie. Anybody can tell you that I didn't see the Russian movie. That I did. And
when a movie comes on of yours, like tonight, if it's playing on television, will you watch it?
It all depends on the movie. Some of them bore the hell out of me.
What movie would you definitely watch? What would you say? This is...
Oh, there he is.
The dog. This. What movie would you say this is good work?
Bring him in.
He's got a dog you wouldn't believe.
What?
What movie would you say yes? This is good work.
I've tried hard in a movie called Burn.
Burn.
Burn. It was a movie about slavery and a slave rebellion. Come here, Tim. Tim, I want you to meet my friend. Tim, come here. Tim, over here, right here. Here. This is Tim.
Look at this.
Now sit down like a good boy. Now shake hands with Larry. Shake hands. That up, boy.
Way to go, Tim.
Now. Good, isn't that good?
This is what kind of breed?
This is a Mastiff.
How heavy is Tim?
Tim is 180 here, Tim.
I'm not going to eat Tim's food.
No, I don't want you to eat it. I want you to just...
Oh, feed him.
Put it in your mouth like this. You're getting this, I'd have to get your glasses like Larry.
We'll be right back with Marlon and Tim. We'll take calls for Tim, too, if your dog wants to call in.
Tim, where's the close-up?
Close-up of Tim. We'll be right back on Larry King Live with Marlon Brando in in Beverly Hills, at home. We'll be right back.
How many Frenchmen have you killed?
I've killed no one. No one. But if I have to sacrifice a few lives for peace, I will do it. even if one of them is my own.
I am Don Octavio de Flores, married to the beautiful Donna Lucita, the light of my life. And you, my friend, you have seen through all of my masks.
That's a film that'll be released in January.
No, Marlon just Brando, to say, Johnny Depp. I just wanted to say that
Don Juan
now,
DeMarco.
Now we're back. No, no, don't talk about that. Larry is too quick off the cuff. There we are. I want to give
you. What kind of effect are you looking for? I'll try to help you.
Which camera? The close-up camera.
Okay.
Larry is hogging the frame, and I wanted it. It didn't
Scene
speak.
Stealing?
I didn't finish the last thing that we were talking about.
But you don't want to talk about Don Juan DeMarco, your new movie? Okay.
I wanted to say that unless we get together, we're gonna fall apart. That we have to come together. That this, maybe we're 140 odd, 150 odd nations, but we're one planet. And we have to find a way to live together without hatred. What goes on in the world is impossible. We have to address that. Now, apropos of that, one of the things that Carl is doing, this is Carl, Caroline? Caroline? Okay, will you give me the names? Oh, yes. I have involved myself with a company called Planetary Design Corporation, which is a company that, by unwritten charter, is designed to reduce the CO2 in the Earth to preserve it for your grandchildren and for mine, which are not going to survive it if we don't pay attention to it. Each one of us, everybody here in this room, sound, gaffers, assistants, whoever it is, we all have to do something to reverse the effects of the CO2.
Right. We're running short on time. What will the company do? What's the company going to do?
The company has already done what I've showed you. Has raised this plant called Salicornia, and Manuel Arango, who is very dedicated to environmental issues in Mexico, and he is teaching children to be aware of their environment, and. I have a feeling that I'm rushing to get this information out, and
well, you know what we'll
it's
have
your
to do?
Show. And
no, no,
I
no, you know what we'll have to do?
Obtrude. What?
You were a terrific guest, if I do say humbly so myself. I know that you do. Will you come back?
Thank you, Larry.
You will do another session with me, and then I will do one with you.
Okay.
We'll go on the road with this.
All right.
Okay? But I want to, they're telling me let's close with a song. Let me just remind you, the book is Brando, Songs My Mother Taught Me. From Random House.
Yes, Harry, I hope I've done well by Random
Harry,
House and
he did
by
well.
You. And thank you very much for
now,
your time.
Now, all I wanted to say.
See the way he interrupts?
Got a date with an angel. We're going to do Got a Date with an Angel.
Okay, let's get together for this. Where's the right camera?
All right, which one we do?
Okay. Bum, 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 bum. Got a date with an angel. You're off key.
Gonna be there at 7. Got a date with an angel. And I'm on my way to heaven.
Got an angel beside me.
Got a
whatever
to guide me. Got a date with an angel. And I'm on my way to heaven.
When the chapel bells ring out.
Gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
Darling. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Marlon Brando. See you tomorrow night with Sid Caesar, Carl Reiner, Mel Brooks.
Oh, I wish I was there.
Alan Dershowitz Monday. Okay. Lauren Bacall next week. Thanks for joining us. Say goodnight, Marlon.
Good night. Don't forget Salicornia from the rest.
Not even Dirch.